Hello everyone, I am Wang Puland, a lecturer from Huawei. Previously, we covered an overview of WLAN troubleshooting. We learned about the general troubleshooting process, including troubleshooting methods and commands. Now, let's look at some specific cases. First, we will examine the troubleshooting of APs failing to go online. Let's first look at the common reasons for AP onboarding failures. Common reasons for AP onboarding failures include, first, not being assigned an IP address, or being configured with the wrong address. This is the first step. We go back to our CAPWAP tunnel setup process. First, when we do the DHCP interaction, if an IP address is not obtained, then obviously communication is impossible. So, commonly, first check whether the AP has an IP address. How do you check if an AP has an IP address? On ENSP. It's quite simple, right? If you are experimenting with ENSP, just double-click on the AP and directly use the display IP interface command. That's a simple method. What's the second method? You can display AP all on the AC, but since the AP is failing to go online, you won't be able to see the information. What else can be done? Look at the DHCP address pool. This is the most direct approach. How do we check the DHCP address pool? We have a set of commands, which is to display IP all, and then add the name of the DHCP pool. For example, the name is pool, or the name is AP, then you add used, this is a very practical secret, display AP pool, then add the AP's address name, and in used, it will show you the IP addresses we are currently using, and the new ones being allocated. Looking at this, you can roughly know whether our AP has obtained an IP address. This is the first part. AP obtaining an IP address. Then there's the issue of an incorrect IP address. Some might use a static IP to configure it directly on the IP to ensure their network. Some might do this if they configure the wrong information. You might want to check, pay attention to which VLAN is for the service, and then which IP segment it is. The second issue is that the network between the AP and AC is not communicating. Returning to CAPWAP, the first step is DHCP. The second step is discovery. If the AC cannot be discovered, there will be issues. Take note of this. If it's layer 2, we basically won't have any problems. If layer 2 can't ping the ASC, what could be the reason? It's basically because you have not allowed the management VLAN, right? Leading to network communication failure. What else could be the issue? Perhaps you have not configured the corresponding port mode, etc. This is layer 2. If it's layer 3, perhaps routing needs to be done, right? Your AP will go to the DHCP address pool location. Perhaps the address pool is on the switch above. Then, whether the switch and the AC's CAPWAP source address can communicate determines whether our AP and AC network can communicate. So the second step is to investigate our AP's gateway. AP first goes to ping the gateway. If the gateway is reachable, then it goes to the switch to ping to see if AC is reachable. It's that simple. The third issue is the AP's authentication failure. So we need to check because usually it is due to adding the AP to our AC using the MAC address. And perhaps you mistyped the MAC address, so your authentication fails, etc. Then it's about the number of APs connected to the AC, exceeding the maximum number of APs allowed in that area. This is something to be aware of. It's a common issue, like with our older IC equipment, for example, the 6005. Usually supports 4 to 8 APs by default, the latest AM series, or the 6805 series, or the 6805 series. And by default, it is 0. So by default, your device won't be able to handle it. Your device won't be able to bring APs online. And then you can use which command. We mentioned earlier the display AP online fail record, which is the complete record of online failures. You can open it, and it will explain to you what specifically caused your AP not to come online. It might tell you it's a license issue. The last one is an AP fault. When there is a problem with the AP, it is indeed an AP issue. Then there could be issues like a PoE switch problem. The first issue is, for example, the cable. My Ethernet PoE supply is broken, such as a broken port on the switch, which can result in one or two ports on the switch failing. The third one I've seen before is a classic power supply issue, insufficient power supply, causing the AP to go offline. What does insufficient power supply mean? By default, a Huawei switch typically reserves about 120 watts for its power module, meaning under full load, it should be within 120 watts. We assign it a power rating. Under normal circumstances, if it's PoE, the power source is the PoE power, which is the battery capacity. We need to be mindful when purchasing how much battery capacity is needed. Depends on how many AP devices you are running. Because a small AP might need about 15 watts, you need to allocate 15 watts. You need to calculate, for example, if we now want to run 10 APs, then we might need 15 watts each, which is 150 watts, right? Then adding on the basic needs of the switch, which uses 120 watts, that would be about 270 watts. So you need at least a 300 watt battery, or perhaps a 500 watt power supply. This is an AP fault, which could also be caused by PoE. This needs to be clear. Let's look at the troubleshooting process for AP online faults. The process is quite cumbersome. Let's take a quick look. The first issue is AP onboarding failure. First, check if the AP is faulty. If not, then proceed based on the AP's status, because the AP may show things like version mismatch, as mentioned before, which means the versions do not match, or the AP is still downloading configurations or updating with a downloading indicator, then you would know. You can check the display AP update information, what the upgrade information looks like. It will display for you exactly where it is in the process. If it's not a fault, then check if the AP has been assigned an IP address. If not, then check the DHCP server. If there is an IP, then check if the connection between the AP and IC is clear. If not, you definitely need to look at static routes, dynamic routes, protocols, and other configurations. If they are also clear, then check if the AP has passed AC's authentication, including MAC address authentication, serial number authentication, etc. If the authentication fails, you can also add it to a whitelist to bypass the MAC address check. Next, check if the AP has exceeded the license number, how many APs can be onboarded to the AC. There are requirements for this. If not possible, you definitely need to load a license. Next is the AP configuration parameters. Whether they match reality, you need to check. If there is an issue with my configuration, because making mistakes is normal, it's about how you resolve the issues after making them. The last one is whether the device hardware is faulty. If it's a live network, the first thing to do is to check if the hardware is faulty, because I might not spend so much time checking various commands. I just look to see if there is a problem with my hardware. If the hardware is fine, then move on to a commonly used approach, which is part of the troubleshooting process.